second to load in. It has to load the loading screen. That's how many goddamn mods I have in this fucking game. I unlocked my phone and it had like sound things open. Yay. It's loaded a bit. Look at those pretty planets. We're gonna go there eventually. That plane, I think it's flying inverted. Might not be though. Yeah. Anyone in chat have any conversation topics we can talk about while it loads? Yeah, that's a cool plane. Doing a ritual there. Gonna sacrifice Bob to the Kraken. Make sure they have a good launch. Yeah, I like how with Summer's visual pack, you can't even see the surface of Eve, which is how it should be. Because it is supposed to be Venus, after all. What the Discord call. Thanks, Interstellar reference there. A good movie until the end. I'm not going to spoil it in case anyone in here wants to watch that movie. But God, it's fucking great until the ending. The ending fucking sucks. Like, God. Like, it almost ruined the whole movie. For some people, it did ruin the whole movie and they hate the movie. But I still like it because it's really good until the ending. But yeah, and also the soundtrack is fucking great. It's really good. Unload already. We're slightly over halfway. It doesn't look like it, but like this bit of the loading bar happens pretty much all at once. wanna launch some rockets. I wanna go to space. Load faster. That boy do be on Duna. Hey, look, it's Duna again, and there's Ike. There we go. It's almost loaded. This is like the last step. Come on. Expansion loading's complete. Come on, man. I want to launch a rocket. Loading. There we go. Yeah. All right. So yeah, I think just before the stream, we launched a comm satellite constellation into orbit. So now we're going to make a mapping satellite. That's the whole reason why I launched that comm satellite. Alright, so for the mapper, let's do this one. Do we need reaction wheels? I mean, it'd be good to have. Yeah, we're gonna use one for reaction wheels on it. Alright. Got that one, got that core. Let's start with the fuel tanks. Assume an Oscar C isn't gonna be quite a heavy craft. Quite heavy compared to how small it is. It'd be a dense, that's the word. Alright, so we got 2 kilometers delta V with just that. We need a battery. For when it is dark. Okay. We're gonna need some solar. Do plenty of solar, because if I remember rightly, the scanner equipment is kind of power hungry. No, it's not communication. It is science, source science. There it is. Now we got some new, got some new science there. It's new. New to me, at least. Ah, there is. Spectral scanner. Don't need six of them. And radar altimeter. Let's put it on the opposite side to hopefully get rid of some torque. Yep, now we only have 0.04 meters of torque. Perfectly manageable. I don't need any of that science, because I think I already have that. Altimetry low res, but I think this also gets altimetry low res. Yep. It's a wider FOV though, so I might probably will do that actually. What's this one's FOV? 3? Yeah. It'll be fine. It'll be fine, I tell ya. Alright. We don't have swallow decouplers yet, so I'm just gonna do that one. And then bearing for more aerodynamics. And this thing can make orbit, so it has enough. So I just need probably like 2 kilometers still to be in the first stage. Look at this tiny little spacecraft. It's so cute. Oh my god! That's a really goddamn high thrust to weight ratio. It needs a bit more fuel though. This thing's so funny. Oh man, glory to Arusha. Burn Osea to the ground. It needs a bit more than this. There we go. Am I happy with that much fuel? No. We need more. This should be good. Yeah, that's plenty. Mappy boy. Oh, I meant to hit launch. Oh wow, we can launch from this screen. Alright. There it is. Launch. There we go. God. So small. It doesn't have an antenna. That's important. This one. That one has a range of 500. Yep. Yep. It does. There we go. I always forget the antennas. God, it always sounds like my fucking incinerated chicken whenever I launch this engine. Wow, this thing, yeah. Oh god. Okay, let's try that launch again. Might want to put some fins on this. We're gonna have to incinerate another chicken. Yeah, if it spins out again, I'm gonna revert to vehicle assembly and put some fins on the first stage. Alright. Maybe more power than that. There we go. And this setup. Surface pitch of 80, heading of 0. Going into a polar orbit. Oh yeah, we need fins. Fins are not negotiable for a rocket this goddamn small. It's like so short and stubby. It looks like the top stage of a rocket, but it is the entire rocket. Just the basic fins, these should do. Keep it pointing the direction we want it to point. This keeps flipping around and breaking up. Need to get more water. And my water bottle has a resonance, like... Yeah. I whack it on my head. There we go. Another chicken bites at us. 07 chicken. 07. Zero and 80. Yeah, there we go. Nice and straight. And let's get this ready for another. The next thing we do. It keep my faster rate ratio at 2. Because otherwise it's just too fast. And I'll burn up a lot of energy just for heat through pressurizing the atmosphere. It's not friction, it's pressurization. Not a misconception. Rockets don't heat up on reentry because of friction. It's because as they go down, they pressurize the air, which causes it to get really hot. Friction probably does count for a little bit of the heat, but not that much. Especially since the pressurized air in front of the capsule put up a little bit of a cushion against friction. Just a second. And then orbital prograde in a little bit. Oh, we need to move this more this way to get our inclination even higher. Oh boy. Because we need to be in a polar orbit. There we go. That should be polar enough. Oh, and we've actually burned a little bit too far. Check that. And hey, look, it wants to be retrograde as well. Thank you. Thank you, Rocket. Burn our down our thing to about 75. Alright, now we want to be prograde. Hopefully the reaction wheels in this rocket can turn it enough. So do I have enough power? Yeah, I have enough power for this. Probably should have launched at sunset, because then it would always have power. But oh well. We're gonna need to start burning pretty soon. Since this orbit is so low and that gravity turn was so shallow, or is it deep steep? I'm not sure which one that is. Alright. I'm gonna start burning about there. Luckily, this rocket has a shit ton of thrust rate ratio. Okay. Closer. Probably do it in like 10 seconds. Oh. We can do it now, actually. Okay. And that's the first stage done. Second stage. Yeah, this thing is a lot slower. Yeah, this thing doesn't have enough thrust weight ratio to do this. Let's do 40. Yeah, I think it has plenty of fuel. And I think we might need more fuel in the first stage. Just so that we can even make an orbit. Because the thing does not have the thrust weight ratio to do that. Does this engine have an alternator? No, it does not. Yeah, I think we're about to hit the atmosphere again. And we don't have nearly enough speed. I don't know. The dream's not dead until it catches on fire. Rules to live by, honestly. Also, I'm not sure I'm even going to have enough fuel to make orbit anyway. Yeah, no. Wait, I burned too much. Too much was lost to gravity. We need a bit more fuel in the first stage. The math does not check out. We did not have enough fuel to keep going. Alright. Probably just even this one. There we go. That's like basically enough to that. This is basically almost an SSTO, the first stages. Which stands for single stage to orbit. For those of you who don't know that. Because most rockets have two stages, because it's more efficient. Or like it's more cost efficient to have a booster stage and then a. And then a orbital insertion stage. But you don't have to have both. You can have just one. God, chickens. You gotta stop going under the launch pad, chickens. Not safe. It's not safe on the launch pad. Fucking like chicken engine ignition like surprises me every goddamn time. I'm never expecting it. I'm not gonna do full throttle though. It's just too fast. Like the thrust rate ratio goes up to like 8. Do at opposite of gravity turn. We gotta do this so we don't start spinning out, and then we're gonna go all the way down to 20. Pulling like 3.5 G's. Yeah, also we gotta do this a bit. Oh boy. I almost just lost a rocket. Oh, there we go. Okay, we're good. We're good. Just pull that orbit. Just pull that orbit marker. Oh, okay. Well, we're out of fuel in the first stage. But we're pretty much almost in orbital velocity, so... Yeah, we just gotta coast to orbit. Thanks to the comm network, I still have, oh, actually not thanks to the comm network, you can still see the KSC from here. Actually, we need more inclination. Yep, we can do, I think that's actually a good enough inclination. What's the inclination? 88, yeah, and we have an FOV of 30 degrees. That should be good enough to get the poles, hopefully. Oh, this one has an FOV of 1.5 degrees, though, so I'm gonna actually need to... Normal plus, I believe? Yeah. There we go. And then prograde, because we gotta start burning soon. Yeah, we have a lot more speed this time, so we should be able to make orbit. I'm gonna start burning at about 30 seconds to node. Actually, no, I'm gonna do like 20 seconds. Yeah, this thing just does not have that much for us. I should have probably started burning earlier, but oh well. Let's do that trick we were doing again. Degrees, please. This might be fine. Again, we are going to enter the atmosphere, I think. We might not, though. Oh, wait, what? Oh, we lost connection. What? Is this antenna not on? No, it's on. Oh, it's out of range. Yeah, it's more than... I need a better antenna. You know, I need the bigger antenna. I need this one. It says S, but it's actually S for supersized. You'd think an S moniker would mean it's smaller, but no, it's actually way bigger. It has like 3 times the range, I think. Oopsie. Accidentally clicked out of the window. Alright. Execute. Oh boy. No! I need to move the fins down. I added more fuel and forgot to move the fins down. Keep the center of lift as far behind the center of mass as possible. Look, there it is. Or at least not that far ahead of it. There we go. Let's add more fins, actually. Maybe get it even closer. Yeah, there we go. That should be good. I think it should be pretty stable, hopefully. It's not quite behind the center of mass, which means it would, even if I turned it around, it would still want to face forward. But should be good enough for the gimbal and the reaction wheels to be able to keep it pointing straight. Oh, forgot to turn on SAS. Execute that for now. And then we want... First of all, we want to throttle down. Pitch at 80 and a heading of 0. Throttle up a bit. I don't want to go max throttle because then I'll just start going too fast and be in quite a bit of danger of just completely flipping. 40. Who lives on the side of a mountain? I can't believe I just noticed that. Look at that city block right there. Just right on the side of a mountain. Anyway. Then we're going to want to go orbital prograde in just a little bit once it gets down a little bit lower. So we want to do this. Oh, wow. That's quite a high apoapsis. Honestly, I think going to a higher apoapsis and then burning to go lower would be better. So I think I'm going to keep that, actually. We're high enough there, so I'm going to ditch that. There we go. Yeah, if we burn higher, then we'll have more time to get into an orbit. Wowie. Yeah, we don't need that low of an apoapsis. But we need higher than that. For periapsis, I mean. Yeah, that's good enough. Go to node. A little bit of burn so you can actually maneuver to the node. In fact, actually, we gotta start burning now! Wait, let's do a new maneuver. That's the perfect periapsis, actually. Oh. Thanks for the alert. Alright, yeah, we gotta start burning. B. Maybe I should upgrade this engine into something that's not so piddly. Just look at that tiny little ass engine. For the record, from here to here is about half a meter. So that engine's maybe like 4 inches across. It's tiny. It's like a model rocket engine. You know, I still have not. I wanted to use this engine because it's because I never use this engine, but it's just too bad. It's just an awful engine. It just doesn't produce any thrust. Like, if you can actually get into an orbit, it's fine because it's quite a it's quite an efficient engine. But yeah, the problem is getting into orbit. So put away the alarm clock. We don't need the alarm clock. Not yet, at least. Eventually, it'll be very handy. Yeah, we still got connection. Even though we're quite far away. Hopefully this reaches around the entire planet. If not, I will have to put an even bigger antenna on it. Let's also point a bit more this way. Increase the, actually, no, orbit is more important. Yeah. Yeah, re-entering would be very bad. And I would have to restart the launch again with a better engine. Once that gets out of the atmosphere. 40. 50. 60. 70. Nope. No, that's just barely in the atmosphere. I mean, that's probably fine because we're not even going that much lower. Like that low in the atmosphere will probably lose like only a few meters a second of delta V. But I do want. All right, that should be good enough. What is your ideal altitude? 70 kilometers. I think as is yours. Yeah. All right. So now what we do is we look here. And we were in retrograde until it's a nice and circular orbit. And 70. All right. Yeah, we lose connection over the poles for a bit, but I think that's okay. Anyway, when do we gotta start burning? Oh, like about 4 seconds before the burn. All right, or before the note. There we go. And let's aim normal. Yeah, that puts the solar panels into the sun. And then we can the scanners. And check to make sure that we're not losing power. Oh. Oh. I think we can only run one at a time with our current tech level. Yeah. Or can we even run this multispectral scanner at all? Yeah, we can. That uses 0.8 and this uses how much does it use? This uses 1. All right. Yeah, let's do radar first. Let's pull up the ScanSat map. Wherever it is, there it is. Owie, maps. We can just start mapping the planet. Look at it go. Oh, it's almost got everything. 99.2. 99.9. Okay, 100%. I don't know why it's saying zero, but anyway. And then analyze the data and get 7.5 science. Oh, we ran out of power transmitting the data. Stop transmission. Where's the deactivate? No. I don't want to deactivate. I wouldn't be able to activate it again, I don't think. Oh boy. I should pack more batteries, huh? I thought one battery would be enough to transmit one piece of data. Stop that. Stop scanning. That should give us quite a bit of power generation. Okay, so science packet costs a point of 15 charge. How many packets is this worth? 20 mits. So I need a... Okay. This has 20 mits of data. And a package size of this is 2. So I need 150 charge. So let's play it safe and go like for 200. There we go. And we can start the multispectral scanner, which will not take as long because it has much wider field of view. Yeah, look at that. You can see the mountains and stuff. Wowie. I don't think we have anything that can see anomalies because I kind of do want to go check those out. So I don't know why it's rotating like this. You do have power, right? Oh. Oh, there's no connection, so it's just trying to endlessly rotate. Ah, whatever, this is fine. Switch to biome, because that will tell me how done we are. Look at it go! Yeah! Is that 100%? Yeah, it is! Alright. So yeah, the satellite's done now. We can probably deorbit it if we wanna do that. But yeah, look at that. Okay, this one we don't actually have enough charge to transmit back. That's... I'm gonna see if I can put it down softly. Because then we can just get it from here. If not, we're gonna have to send up another fucking satellite. Or hold on, I think I have a plan. I have a plan. This might work. This could work. It probably won't work. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna give it a second. Give it a second. All right, new thing, please. We're not even gonna save this. We're gonna take a probe core. Like any of these antennas will do. One antenna. We're gonna put a multispectral scanner on there. And like a bunch of power things. Oh, I just realized I don't even need the power, actually. The power is not gonna be helpful. Because I can just recover it, and I don't even have to transmit the data back. I think I still need the antenna so I can connect to the probe core, but I think I can just do this, analyze data, yeah, keep the experiment, and then recover. Don't even need to transmit it. I think I can only do that around Kerbin, so I have to make sure there's enough power to transmit the data. When I go to a different planet. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to send another probe over there with a scanner to transmit the data back. Yeah, that's 11 science right there. Actually, not even that good, because... Oh, that's the wrong building. This building is the one we want. Yeah, we don't even have enough science to do anything here. Who do I even want next? Anyway, probably fuel systems, because as the at least part of it. Yeah, the external fuel duct. That's a good item. All right, so let's map either the moon or Minmus. I think I got the extension that lets me do polls. I don't think I have it set up, actually. I downloaded it, and I haven't set it up yet. So say a 1 for Moon, 2 for Minmus. Whoever's the first one to type in chat will be the one who wins. It'll be fast. If anyone's even in chat. I haven't seen any messages since I started streaming this game. Alright. Okay, so first of all, to do a... whichever body we decide to go to, we are going to need a satellite in orbit that is capable of having communications with the moon or Minmus. So, we need a much stronger antenna. I believe that one will be strong enough. Alternatively, we could go for this one, which is a dish antenna, which I think is lighter. Yeah, it's lighter. But this one is bigger, so I'm gonna do it. It's 80 megameters is a decent range. That one's 90 though. we're doing this one. We're doing this one. Alright. And yeah, no one's typed in chat, so I assume there's no one here. It's gonna need quite a bit of power to transmit data, because how many per bit is this... Oopsie. Is this thing to take? How does it say? Oh, yeah, there we go. Package size 2 mits, 15 charge per packet. So, we're gonna need a lot of power. We're just gonna put down, like, a bunch of batteries. And we're also gonna put more batteries on the side. There we go, there should be enough power. And this satellite's gonna be quite heavy. So we're gonna do an Oscar D. Wowie, that's a big fuel tank. And we're not gonna use the Ant, because it's a shitty-ass engine. We're gonna use the Spark, because it's way better. Like, how much... This one has 320 vacuum ISP. This one... As three. Why would you ever use this engine? Why? I mean, it is really cheap, but this one's better in every other way. It has like 10 times the thrust and 5 more ISP, which admittedly is not that much more, but it still counts a bit. Yeah, and this one also, I think, has a wider vectoring range as well. Oh, this one doesn't even vector at all. Yeah, it's a dumbass engine. Why would he ever use it? The Spark is better. Let's give it a bolt tail. Because that's fun. Actually, let's do... bolt tail. Orange gray. Make this one orange gray. I can make it white, though. Yeah. White and orange is a pretty good combo. Yeah. God, the Ant is such a terrible engine. Alright. Anywho. I'm gonna need a... one of these. There we go. Oh, need solar panels. Good thing I didn't forget that. It has an antenna. Oh, it's gonna also need a, it's gonna need a omnidirectional antenna. We're gonna stick that down here. Yep. And... what else? What else will this need? Oh yeah, solar panels. That's right, that's what I was doing. It doesn't really need, like, that much power in the first place. It just needs, or it doesn't need to generate that much power. It just needs to store a lot of power, because the times it is going to be using a lot of power is going to be quite rare. So that much power should be enough. How much does this thing use passively? 0.82. How much does solar panels produce? 0.3. We're going to need more solar panels. Only 3 of these are going to be in range at a time. So we're going to replace 1 set of batteries with some solar panels. And there we go. This should be good. Yeah, 0.6, and then these ones will be 0.15. Yeah, that should be good enough. How much power does this produce? 2.4? Yeah, we'll put that on the next one. For now. You know, do we even need that? No. We do not need that. I think 2 of these will do. Oh. And... let's use Oh, this thing needs fins, probably, if I were to guess. This is quite short and stubby. This time we're going east, so don't need to adjust the heading. Yeah, I'm gonna have to be very careful with this if I don't put any fins on. I'm gonna try launching without fins first, though. It'll probably go bad, but that's only a probably, so that's not good enough for me to stop doing this. Oh yeah, if I lower down, it needs to use a lot of thrust to do that. To keep it pointing straight. Cause like look how much that engine's turning. Okay. Oh nope. Yeah, there it goes. All right. Fins. Let's use the big fins. Use these fins. That. So might need a bit more fuel. Yeah, that's good. I can add another fuel tank, actually. Oh. There we go. Yeah, and that thing will want to point straight automatically, so even if I turn it all the way around, it will want to keep going straight. Alright. Give it a second. All right. Yeah. Let's just get going. Surface 80. God, I'm so used to launching, like, huge-ass rockets that have pretty low thrust-to-weight ratio, so this is actually pretty nice. Piercing the big blue sky. My rocket that looks kind of like a dick with no balls. Should add boosters on there for balls. Oh, we're good to keep going. Let's go 40 now. Down a little bit though. Right. Yeah, let's do orbital prograde now. Really get down. Also, his engine is silent. I think I'm using a different engine this time. This one doesn't have any engine sounds. Still, let's work with waterfall, though, so that's nice. And then we're going to launch to an orbit of around 400. Kilometers. There it goes. Hey, check out this cool moth I found. Whoop, there it goes. I just realized I have an entire fuel tank I gotta use as more batteries or more solar panels. Oh well. I don't know why I was limiting myself to just putting power stuff on the batteries. You can put them literally anywhere, it does not matter. Also, if you've not seen the video where it's like, hey, check out this cool moth I found, please look it up. It is very funny. Whoop, there it goes. My son of a bitch. Oh, we are burning way too high. That should be a good orbit, though. That's a fine orbit. I don't need to lower it again. I was aiming for a similar orbit as the other comm satellites, but it actually does not matter. In fact, actually, I don't even have enough fuel to make orbit that high, so... Well, I can make orbit. It's just not going to be circular. Which will bother some people, but it will not bother me, so I am fine. Alright. You know what? You can do the burn. Right, flight computer? Yeah. There we go. That's good enough. That's probably good enough, right? Yeah. We only have 4 meters a second of delta V. Do you know what? We're gonna burn it. We're gonna burn those 4 meters a second of delta V. There it goes. Perfectly circular orbit. Just don't look at it. See, look, it's circular enough, you see? Anyway. Please look at... Let's do the moon. Everyone does Minmus first. Why not do the moon first? Actually, technically, I did Minmus first because I did a flyby. Yeah, I did Minmus flyby before I did a moon flyby, but, you know, I got some science. I got science from both. I've done both moon and Minmus. Just the orbit, though. Not actually landed. Alright. Next, we make the mapping satellite. For both the moon and Minmus, I'm gonna map them both, but not in the same launch, probably. I could do it in the same launch. I'm not going to do it in the same launch, though. It's complicated. That core. So, we're going to want decent amount of power. So, let's see here. 45 times... This is the dish we're gonna need to use. So 15, 2, so it's 45. That is 300 something power. Do three of these. We're gonna need an omnidirectional antenna. This one should be good enough. We'll put two of these on. These ones do more power. No, let's not. Let's not do that. How much does it make burning stuff? Oh. It needs an atmosphere. Burn stuff. But I mean, it works fine as a solar panel, though. But we're not gonna use it. We're gonna use these. OXSTAT photovoltaic panels, my beloved. And then this one is gonna need a lot more fuel. So we're gonna do this absolutely cursed thing and put a 1.25 meter fuel tank on it. And a 0.625 meter engine on it. Alright, that should be plenty of fuel to get and capture at the moon. And then we're gonna put a 1.25 meter decoupler on that 0.625 meter engine to make this absolute abomination. And also we're gonna put some more solar panels on the tank. Alright. Okay, so we're gonna need 800 to make it. I think it's like 200 to capture. That's 1,000. So we need at least 2,000 meters second delta to be in the first stage. But we're gonna be very safe because we're in science mode and we can afford to do that. If this was career mode, I'd probably be cutting it a lot closer. Where's the one that makes it sound like you're absolutely fucking annihilating a chicken? Is it this one? I think it might be this one. No, we're gonna play it safer than that. We're gonna put on another one of these. Oh, we also need a fairing. One of these. 4,000. Let's shoot for like 5,500. That's good enough. Save that. God, I'm sorry. I accidentally unplugged my headset. Yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. I'll be back. Oh wait, this one doesn't have a reaction wheel. Or does it? No, it does not have a reaction wheel. We need some reaction wheels for it then. Command control. It's like 2.5. I don't need that much. Just one. I also have to say physicsless part, so it will not add torque, or it doesn't. Oh, it has a little bit of torque, but I think I would put it here to cancel out a lot of it. Yeah, actually, did I get less putting it here? No, I didn't. Alright. Yeah, put 11. This gyroscope should be able to deal with that. Look how tiny it is. It's so cute. So cute. Alright. We got that. We need fins. Otherwise, this rocket's gonna flip the fuck out. Use these ones. These ones this time. Check my staging. We need more Delta V now. There we go. Now this is gonna map the moon or die trying. I got some more water when I took a bathroom break, but I didn't. So I will just have to thirst. I'm not that thirsty right now though anyway, so we're good. Get launched. Yeah, I think this is the same one that sounds like you just killed a chicken, but for some reason it's not making any noise right now. Surface 80. Oop. And now it just cannot stop spinning. Look at the roll going crazy. Throttle up a bit because we're losing speed. Throttle up even more because we're not going nearly fast enough. All right, there we go. Now we're going fast enough. Throttle back to so we don't waste that much fuel. Like fighting the atmosphere. And 60 in a second. Yep. I'm gonna go 40 in just another second. This rocket's going up real fast. Let's do it now. Go to 40 now. And then... I'm actually going to throttle down so that we get... So that this thing has... This stage lasts longer. Because this is the one with the fins on it. Ditch that because I think now that's just slowing us down. Yeah. Yeah. Helps in the lower atmosphere to reduce drag. But now that we're in the upper atmosphere, we need to reduce weight. Let's do orbital prograde now. Hopefully we don't flip. Okay, no, this is too steep a gravity turn. Going this way. Point forward surface velocity up and then stage. Just need to get more altitude. Calibration here. This is a good thing. Watch through the atmosphere. God, I love the Astronomer's visual pack. Makes the game look so good. And also, now that I don't have that conflicting mod, it's not, like, completely messing up everything. They're basically at orbital speed in the atmosphere. Please do not blow up, Dish. That would not be very cash money of you if you just fucking exploded. I think we're good. I don't think it's gonna blow up, but, yeah. It's getting hot. Target. The Lunar Comm Satellite. Yep. Does have a connection. Wow, we 8 viewers. I think that's a new record. Welcome, everybody. Hope you're enjoying just one really cursed-ass spacecraft. Just going through space, as spacecraft do. But yeah, early science mode designs be like... Yeah, there we go. We're in space now. Let's get a bit more altitude. And there we go. That's a circular orbit. Once we do it, execute. Gonna turn. Yeah, you have the. All right, whatever. Oh yeah, that's right. That's the way this the remote tech works. It doesn't actually go to maneuver until like right before it, like 3 minutes before it, I think. Alright. And now... we focus view. Or we set his target, actually. We don't focus view yet. Alright. We want a little bit of that. We also want... We want a polar lunar orbit. Polar lunar orbit. We're on about 70. Focus fields, focus fields. Node, this one. All right, there we go. Oh, let's try this again. All right. We want about right here. Potentially want a collision course. Oh boy. Let's get that back. Collision course. Alright. Maybe we should do a course correction, actually. Yep, we're just gonna execute that and do an orbital correction at the next, or at the, at the ascending or descending node, because that would be the best place to do it. I don't know why I don't have engine sounds. They'll probably be back next stream. Then boot the game. It just takes too long to boot that I don't want to do it. What's the next node? Oh, we've already passed it, actually. Here. Did I remember the mapping stuff? I didn't. We have to go back. That's a shame. That's... Oh, boy. I'm so good at this game and definitely remember everything. Take it from the top. We want... radar altimeter. And a whatever it is, this thing, multispectral scanner. Take it from the top. I should maybe rush, the extraplanetary launch pads just so I can make a spacecraft in orbit. once again. Now that we actually have the stuff we need. We sure do be launching this rocket into space. So me when I launch a rocket into space. Alright. Open up the throttle. Wordy. Let's open it up full. Full throttle. Actually, no. That's too much. That joke made someone leave. I mean, to be fair, it was a really bad joke. Like, very unfunny. Really need to work on my humor. Not funny. Didn't laugh. Wowie. I didn't even know that. You can mouse over it and you can see what that is. Doesn't work on the moon, though. There's Jewel. Moho. Eve. Or is Eve behind the sun? Oh, Comm Network Probe. Any other planets we can see? They're probably all behind the... Yeah, it's not a planet. Did I miss? Yeah, I don't know. Oh. I was too distracted looking at planets. We have overshot the target orbit that I wanted. It's fine. We can just launch from... We can just, do it from a higher orbit. It'll be ever so slightly less efficient. But this thing has plenty of fuel. So this launch was way less efficient than the last one. Like, I was basically already in orbit by the time I exited the atmosphere. Do I have this mod? Nope, I do not have that mod. Or maybe I do, and I just have to activate it. I suppose better time warp to let you, time warp while you were... Nope, that's not it. Yeah. Or no, it might not be this one. Where is it in here? No, it's not. Yeah, I don't know. Not in that one. This, that's too large. civilian population. That'll be fun eventually. Okay. That's waterfall. Persistent rotation. I think that's the one that lets you thrust through time warp. Momentum. Nope, not momentum. Rotation. Okay. I don't know what there is a mod that lets you thrust through time warp, and I'm not sure which one it is. Yeah. Oh yeah, also this launch was way less efficient. Look at that. I might actually have to redo it. I don't think we have enough fuel to capture. We're gonna give it a shot, though. Because it'll be pretty hype if we get it. There we go. That's what we want. All right, we'll have about 400 meters a second left. I think that's enough to capture. I hope that's enough to capture. It's probably not enough to capture, but we're gonna give it a shot. Also, we need to make the inclination change maneuver as well. You know, all this burn goes, I'm going to grab a bottle of water. It's running automatically anyway because of flight computer. I'll be back after I set this up. We want another comm satellite. There we go. They also activate it. All right. Alright, I'm back. See, the burn's done. So now, what we do is, like, that far. We're gonna do change. That we go into a polar orbit. That we can map. About 70. It as exact as possible because I think the mappers are quite finicky. There we go. And then we're gonna have the flight computer do that burn as well because I'm not sure we're gonna have connection for that one. I would do that one myself because how finicky it is, but I don't think we're gonna have connection. So probably be best not to do it myself. Try to do it myself. Yep, we don't have connection for this burn. Okay, what's the periapsis? 74,000? I mean, that should be good enough. So, we'll keep getting connection again soon. Did I activate this? I did not. Okay, now we should have connection on the other satellite. Yep. 0.04 delay. Alright, now we see if let's switch to the moon view. Moon view. Do we have enough fuel to do a capture? We do. Yeah, this one is a much tighter margin than the previous one was. Because I think we had like a kilometer delta B for the other one. Alright. Will we be blocked by the moon there? We might. I'm not gonna risk it. No risk. No balls. I have zero testicles. I will take no risks. It'll probably end up being fine, but, you know, I don't wanna... I don't want to jeopardize the whole mission just because, because I was like, yeah, I can do this. I can do this myself. Yeah. We are going to need to fix that orbit. Because it is too ovular, and we want it to be about 70 kilometers. As close to 70 kilometers as we can make it. There we go. And this one I will do myself. Because I don't think the, Nope. Not off as well. You know, I don't think the flight computer is accurate enough to do that burn. Let's use this button, because I keep forgetting it's a thing, and I warp past my burns like an idiot. Also, I should quick save. Do that now. Yeah. A thrust limiter on this engine. No, I can be more accurate. Okay. We go to periapsis and we do the same burn. We'll lower our apoapsis. All right. I'll start burning now. Want the apoapsis to be down to about 70. Alright, now we can map the moon. Let's adjust our angle to be more in line. That's good. Now we're more in line with the sun. We're producing more power. Let's create our scan. And start the multispectral scan. And yeah. We got a lot of power. Okay. Wasn't quite what I was expecting. Kind of like jolted. Look at it go. Wow. Let it catch up. Wait, something go wrong. We're only at 2.8% scan. We're scanning, right? Yeah, you are. That was a waste of 30 days, but it's not like time really matters in science mode. Oh, that's what happened. Ran out of electric charge. Oh, we're on the dark side of the moon, though. You know what? This is scanning the surface. This will get it eventually. Since there. Eve, Jewel, and all the planets. That should be good. We don't produce enough power for like some weirdness with the time warp. Oh no. Okay, we have to adjust the hold on. Wait a minute. Stop the scan. Nope, we're out of power. Yeah, because the angle's too high, and it's not actually producing enough power for the entire, Yeah, we have to... There we go. What we're gonna do is we're gonna angle it like this. Angle it like this. And then... No. What we're gonna do is we're gonna angle it like this. We need to angle it vertically so that the sun, when the moon orbits Kerbin, it keeps going around. Like the sun will always be on the solar panels. That should be good enough. No, I still can't time warp too fast, otherwise I do lose power. You get some RPGs or something. I wonder when I get those. I don't think you get those until, like, quite late. It's getting there. It's just gotta clean up a bit. Wait, hold on. How are we with the multispectral? I think it's the wider one, right? We're at like 78% on that one. And with the radar, we're not quite at 100% yet. Yeah, we're like almost there with the radar. There's like a few big spots we're missing because of the because I don't think the multispectral works when it's dark on the surface, but the radar does because it's radar. But we're getting it. We're almost there. Looking very moon today. All right, we're almost there. I think that might be the last one. Oh, we're at 99.9. What is it? What are we missing? We're probably missing some radar. In which case, I will turn off the, Okay, we don't have connection right now. Probably because we're on the wrong side of the moon. Yeah, there we go. We turn off the multispectral, right? Yeah, hold on. Let's turn off the radar just to see. We have 100% multispectral. Oh, we don't have quite 100% on either. So I'm just going to do this. Oh, okay. Can't quite do that. You want 99.9%? That's probably good enough. Right? Yeah, we're at 99.9% on both, I think. Yeah, that's good enough. We're gonna send that back. All right, we got the science from the moon. Space Center. What next? Probably moon landing. Yeah, let's land on the moon with a rocket. That'll give us plenty of science. I'll probably wait till I have better power before I scan any other planets with a map. See, everyone lands on Minmus first, because it's the easier moon to land on, but let's give the moon some love. Also, we're going to go to Drez. Nobody ever goes to Drez. I mean, for good reason. It's kind of a boring place. It's just, like, kind of gray, and so it's kind of hard to get to. And it doesn't give you that much science. But Drez needs love, too. We're going there. We're going to go say hi to Drez. Eventually. Not this stream, probably. Alright. Moonlander time. Actually, first it's science time. We're probably going to do a direct descent rather than Apollo style. Because I don't really have a three-person command pod. And also because Apollo style isn't really as that efficient in this game. Okay, so we don't have enough to get anything fun. But we could get more parachutes. Wouldn't that be something? Actually, I think that's, like, we can either get, like, plane parts, which are, we can get plane parts, which are kind of not good in KSP, because you can just use rockets. Or we could get more parachutes. Which does lead to better command modules, so actually that would probably be good to get. I really want that explosion. We'll have plenty, yeah, we'll have plenty of, science when we get back from the moon. So we're gonna go for this. Got it. Yeah, we got floats. Yeah, command modules will probably be good, because then we can actually carry more people into space. Imagine that! Alright! Waiting for it to load. Alright. I mean, we could do Minmus, though, because then we could just leave the... No, we wouldn't be able to get science if we just left the thing in orbit. We have to land it. There's a reason why people go to Minmus first, but I'm going to the moon first. But that's for... Space Station. We could do a Space Station. Yeah, we're gonna do a space station first, actually. THNKR Research Lab. Oh. I don't think we have that. Whoopsie. Yeah, how do I get the research lab? Yeah, we could put a space station in orbit, get the science from that. Because I have space station science, which adds some long-term science projects to space stations. And then we would have enough research to get some more science for the moon mission. But I think, but it says we need a science module, which is that one. No, this one. Okay, no, it's not that. Exploration? Yeah. We need advanced exploration first, which is 160 science. So we can get that after this mission. So yeah, after this mission, we're gonna build a space station. And yeah. we'll have a space station and get the science from that. Some station science. Because I have a mod that makes space stations actually useful. I mean, I could do an unmanned lander. I'm not gonna. What do we have for ground? We have actual landing struts. That's good. All right. Let's get everything on here. We don't need an antenna, but yeah, we don't need an antenna, so I'm not gonna put one on. We'll have a pilot for making maneuver notes. Science Junior. We're gonna put a service bay. Service bay? No, that's not. That it? No. There. That's what I was looking for. Service bay. And then inside the service bay. Let's rotate that so it looks nicer. And then we're gonna want a barometer. And a thermometer. Any other science that we got? Yeah, I think these need a research lab. We can't get that yet. Yeah, just because low resolution temperature, so we need that. All right. And now this needs, I think, 2 kilometers delta V will do it. How much? That's 345. This is 330, so this is better. Alright. Extra fuel tank. Yeah, 3 kilometers delta V will definitely do it. And on the moon, this has enough. Yep, that is more than enough thrust to weight ratio. Landing gear. And then I think we can have EVA science experiments as well. I think there are some of those. Where is it? I have. No, I don't think we've unlocked any yet. So yeah, all we can do is a ground sample. We could bring a rover. Oh, speaking of snacks, I completely forgot I have the snacks mod, so I'm gonna need to put some snacks on here. These are in the utility, right? No, where is it? I could have sworn snacks were in utility. Cargo? Kind of science. Neck. Yeah, Necton. How many days? That's 100 days? Actually, how much is this? Yeah, I think that would be necessary if we were going to, yeah, I think 16 days should be enough for a moon mission. I think that would be necessary if we were going to Midness, but we're not going to Midness, we're going to the moon. So, yeah, the snacks and the capsule should be fine. We need a parachute, and a heat shield. We're gonna put a heat shield on here. Because I'm not sure if the capsule has enough up later for a moon return. Um, Oh yeah, this is gonna need some reaction wheels as well, because it doesn't have any. So wow, look at all these parachutes we have now. We got airbags and parachutes and all that good stuff. Oh, we need a decoupler. Didn't I have a engine better than 330? Oh yeah, that one does better. That's also way too big, so I'm not gonna use it. You have 382, but you need liquid methane, which I don't think we can do. Oh, we can do. We can do. Methane. Liquid methane, there we go. Does it use methane in an oxidizer? Yes. Oh, it's a tiny engine. Need more oxidizer though. Do you know what? I'm not gonna mess with that. I think I'm just gonna stick with the Terrier. That was giving me good enough fuel. Yeah. They have got the science. 2.5 kilometers enough. Because we have plenty of weight to spare. Now let's do this. Just so that it doesn't become too wide. The landing legs. So yeah, they're going down. You have a nice wide base. Yeah, we got now we got out 3 kilometers. I think that's enough. If we can get this entire thing into orbit, that should be enough. Let's go wide enough. Nope. All right, we're gonna put some aerodynamic caps on these then. Yeah, we only lose like 60 each. This fuel tank. Look how tall it is. Whoopsie. It's the wrong button. Oh, it's the Windows keys. Alt-tab out of the game. First one, it sounds like a dying chicken, that one. No, that's not enough Delta D. We're gonna make this into a heavy. I think that's still not enough Delta V. Because we want to put this thing into orbit. So we're going to make it up. Whatever that is. A super heavy? Yeah. Alright. We don't have fuel systems, so I can't make those on the drop tanks. That would be nice if I... Yeah. It would be nice if I could do that, but I don't... I can't. I don't have the necessary research. Alright. Ooh. No. Wait, yeah, we can. We can do this, actually. But we can... These on decouplers. launch, a couple, and those go. That gave us a lot more fuel. Okay. Yeah. Do we have struts? Put some struts on the bottom here, far away from the connection, just to make sure it doesn't, fuck up. Alright. Got a good rocket here. Good rocket going. But that's inside of that, so we're gonna want to lower these boosters a bit. Use these as well. Yeah! I pressed the wrong button. Oh boy, I meant to clip the crew. I don't think I can. I think the only way to get rid of this is through the leave and come back of the VAB. So do that, I will. We want to make sure we have the scientists in here. Yep, there we go. Can't wait till the late game when we're like building colonies and shit on the surface of bodies so that we can launch rockets from like the moon and Minmus. Super chicken destruction, but oh well. They look cool, even if they don't sound that, like... That fucking noise. Let's turn that off. Settings? Oh yeah, there we go. Alright. I don't like that. Deep. Throttle down a bit, so we don't. Waste too much in the atmosphere. All right, there we go. quite an aggressive gravity turn, because that's always been my most efficient launches, is when I do very aggressive gravity turns. Okay, so we're starting to do a 40. And then a 30. Let's do this, so it starts going immediately. The drop, because I'm afraid that it's gonna, like, absolutely fucking annihilate. Let's do orbital prograde. There we go. Yeah, I was afraid that one of those boosters was gonna ram the main booster and then destroy it, and then I'd have to abort the mission. Yeah, we're going to space. Get us! Burn Osea to the ground. Fuck you, Mobius One. Bitch. We're almost at 100 kilometers. Do I have any reaction wheels on this? Well, we're going back. We're going back for the reaction wheels. Because I have no kind of control, which is going to be very important for the landing. I mean, the engine has a gimbal, but that just ain't good enough. We need some actual, like, gyroscopes. Alright. Now that I actually have gyroscopes on here, this should... I'll actually be able to turn. Wowee. Start gravity turning immediately. Engine effects. Don't get that in the stock game. Unless you do now. I don't know if you get engine lighting in the stock game. But yeah, you don't get clouds in the stock game, I know that. Or cities, or any of that stuff, even if the city is on the side of a mountain. Which is wild. It's a real work of civil engineering there. Just Mountain City. I guess it looks good from space, but it is right near the launch pad, so you can see it. You want that's enough. That's enough for that. 40. And throttle up. And get into orbit. Alright. Yep. 40. And then 30, because we have quite a bit of vertical speed. Still going up quite fast. Do this again. Oh, not that. That in the same stage as that. And then we'll go orbital prograde. Wish the rocket had sound. That'd be nice. I don't know if there's too much conflicting and I'm getting rid of the sounds because, I do have a real plume for rocket sounds, but I think it also does rocket engine effects. Because, yeah, the rockets sound real cool with real plume. But, yeah, might be causing issues. Sure do be climbing. We will make land on the moon. Glory of Arusha. Our Stonehenge will block out the sun. More Ace Combat references. I'm full of them. All right, take two on the whole orbit thing. Do a nice orbit. Can you select computer? No, I can't. I need a probe. So I'm gonna have to do this myself. Mode, please. So yeah, this thing can make an orbit. In fact, it will also be able to do the first part of our translunar injection. We're gonna give the moon estrogen. It's gonna be a translunar injection. Carry up a good name, this is a knock on my That's close enough to circular. Alright. So. Little bit less, a little bit less burn, so we can get into a nice 30-kilometer moon orbit. Okay. Well, 30 kilometers, actually, 15 will do, 16 will do. All right. Please look at node so I can time warp. Thank you. Look at that moon. We're gonna go at about, what would be a good time to go at? Probably a minute, because the first stage is gonna burn out really fast, and then the second stage is gonna take a while. So what's with the two different Delta Vs on stage 3? That's weird. Anyway. Oh, I time warp way too fast, okay. Okay, here we go. Whatever. This should do fine. Because I don't know how long any of y'all have been playing, or if any of y'all play Kerbal Space Program, I'm not sure who's still watching. Like, in early Kerbal Space Program, there was no maneuver nodes, or, like, I think the map came before the moon. But the way you remember the moon, when to burn for the moon is that when it came over the horizon, that's when you should start burning. So I think we're still good, because it's coming over the horizon now. Because I think it's still a thing. Do we have Rastroprop in here? No, we don't. All right. Rastroprop's a fun mod. That's a good periapsis. Yep. All right. And then we do a capture burn. Oopsie. Here we go. Okay, we're in lunar orbit. 16 seconds. Rumble Surfer hurting. Alright. We're making orbit. Orbit is being manufactured. And there we go. So minimum stay here. Let's say body probably. Minimum safe is 10,000. Okay, we're good. Where do we want to land? Probably that crater wants to stay time. That crater right there. Up, eclipse. Beautiful. All right. Gonna start burning right about now. All right, we got an impact time thing. So yeah. We also want surface velocity minus. Coming in. That off. You landed the sub crater. We're not gonna land in the sub crater, but I'm gonna stop burning for a little while. Get a little bit closer. Alright. Play the landing gear. Do I have a mod that's, oh, I don't think the landing gear's long enough. I'm gonna have to put this on real gentle. Do I have a mod that makes it so, like, you don't get engine or landing gear sounds in space? I mean, it makes realistic sense, but I would still rather have them than not. What's the impact time? I think that impact time is wrong. Yeah, that's more like it. Alright. Gonna wait till 15 seconds and start burning again. Okay, actually, that's pretty close to a suicide burn. Never mind, that's very far from a suicide burn. A suicide burn is when you lower your velocity right when you hit the ground. Not doing that. Although that is the most efficient way to do a landing. Because, yeah, it's called a suicide burn, because if you get it slightly too late, you just fucking die. Let's do 10 seconds, because, again, I want to keep it on the safe side. Do a bit more, probably 5 seconds now. 8, I'm watching this number here. 6, 5. For now. I think we're good on the landing gear front, but it's going to be a very close call for landing, for if the engine touches or not. Oh, we're good. Yeah, Leininger is in fact tall enough. Okay, you can stop with that now. Also, I realized I didn't put any solar panels on this. The power is literally only coming from the command pod and the engine, which I think this one has an alternator. But yeah, anyway, let's get our science. Conduct material study. Yeah. 50 science from that. That's nice. Very nice. And observe the goo. It's another 20 science. I can do a crew report. That's another 10 science. Really, don't have a crew report for landing on the moon? Really? Yeah, we need the barometer and thermometer. Okay, that's another 24 science. And another 16 science. Let's get an EVA report. Okay, let's store that. And get out. To EVA report from the air. Another 12. Plant a flag. Moon landing for glorious Erusia. Mobius 1 can suck my cock. There we go. Fuck you, Mobius 1. Take a surface sample. Yeah, science. Fuck yeah, science. Alright, I think we have enough fuel that we can go to a nearby biome. Take a look. There's a nearby biome. Open up a oh yeah, there we go, open up zoom map. Alright, so if we want to go to a new biome, not that much. Nope. Not closer. Farside Crater. We go about over here. Yep, go about a few degrees west. We get to a new biome east. Alright. Let's get this map up. Oh, that's not going to be useful. Well, we're just going to wing it. Where are we gonna hit? Yeah, that's not anywhere near close enough, so let's do this. Give it a bit more speed. This is probably not worth it. But fuck it. Let's just see. If it turns out not being worth it, let's do a quick save. There we go. Right. Yeah. because, yeah, from that quick save, I should be able to make another orbit. Ooh, actually, yeah, we don't have enough fuel to land and get back up, so we're gonna have to go into... We're gonna have to go into orbit. Alright. Do an apoapsis of, like, 15 kilometers. Okay, good thing I checked that, otherwise we would have been fucked. 10, 12, 15, 15. Yuna? Or, no, Sarnus. Look meant to be Saturn. And also, once we're in orbit, I can get Bob to collect all the science that we gathered. They're burning at 8 seconds. Eight. And we're in orbit again, I think. Yeah. Alright. So to get back to Kerbin, need to start burning. Let's go aim for a periapsis of around 30 kilometers. Usually a good safe altitude. Not too low, but also not too high. As you go too low, you'll hit the thick atmosphere going way too fast and burn up. But if you go too high, then you won't actually re-enter. Like, you'll just enter into another orbit and have to go again. Which we might not have enough snacks for, so... Now we have to get Bob out to get the science before I forget and leave all the science in the pod to burn up in the atmosphere, which would be bad. Once we get... Once we re-enter, I'm going to get hit next there and just look at that. There we go. Move that over here. Let's get Bob. Go out and add the science. Movie. Collect that data. Collect data. Collect that data. There we go. I think that's everything, right? We got that. We got that. We got that. And we got that. Good to go back in. Come on. Come on. There we go. Warp here, please. Nope. Warp here.
Allow no agreement to exclude him.
Yeah, that says we're gonna go into another orbit, but we are not. Alright, now that we're in the atmosphere, I'm gonna aim this way. And ditch that. And then we're gonna go surface retrograde. Oh, this thing doesn't have any reaction wheels, so we're just gonna have to rely on the aerodynamics to point us retrograde. Which it will. To get a little bit deeper in. Plus, this thing has some ablator, just not that much. Yeah, look at that. It's heating up a bit and using up some ablator, but this thing is probably taking the brunt of it. Yeah. That's why we have a heat shield. Go through the atmosphere. We're going so fast through the atmosphere. This is what it would look like if we're going 8 kilometers a second. Except also we'd probably be dying because that would produce so much heat. There we go. Turn down. We can ditch the heat shield. Hopefully it doesn't come back and hit us. Holy shit! That was almost bad. Coming down. Yeah, that would have absolutely destroyed us. If it had hit us. It would just have been like, BAM! However, since this pod doesn't have reaction wheels, there would have been nothing I could do to make it not hit us. I'd just have to press it again. I'd just have to load the quick save, press it again, and hope. Alright, we're coming down. Also, let's quick save, just in case we explode when we hit the ground, which is a possibility. I'll try to make sure that I don't do it in time, but that there's no promises. Also, I think the heat shield just hit the ground. And wait for it. We're probably gonna start rolling down a hill, actually. Nope, we're good. We can recover the vessel and get all the science. I could have had Bob get out and put down a surface sample, and then that would have gotten me even more, but I forgot, so I didn't do it. Yeah, we got quite a bit of science now. Let's get the research lab so that we can get even more, which is going to be in space for space exploration and into advanced exploration. Oh, we need like 10 more science. Hold on. I can get that. Where's the first launch? That's not the first launch. Whatever, we just need to put down a pod, and then we can take a surface sample at the launch pad. We can do a material bay and a surface sample at the launch pad. And that should give us the 10 science we need. And then we can do a space station, and I'll probably end stream after the space station. Because I've been going for, it's 9, or no, that's 7. No, that's 9. So, I've been going for 6 hours. I think this is my longest stream yet. It says I've only been going for 3 hours, but that's because, for the VOD, I stopped and started streaming again. Because I switched games twice. So, I started at 3 with Kerbal Space Program. Went back to Starbound because my friend I was planning on doing that with today came online. And then switched back to Kerbal Space Program. Probably RimWorld. RimWorld would be fun to play. Also give me more to talk about because a lot of this is just like radio silence. Anyway, we need a new thing. Just put down a pod. Because I don't think I've taken any of the launchpad sciences. So, no, not that. I want the Science Junior. A goo. Oh, I have cacti. Wait, we could put a space telescope. We also have the enhanced multispectral scanner. Probably want better power before we do that. We got that. What am I looking for? Oh yeah, more signs. We want a barometer. We can do a barometer from the launch pad. We want a thermometer. Do that from the launch pad. And yeah. We're just gonna take all the signs from the launch pad. And then we'll have enough signs to get a research lab for a space station. And then we can do space science. Because I have the mod that makes space stations useful. Material study, observe the goo, log pressure data, and log temperature data. Did I take a crew report from the launch pad? No, I have not. EVA report. And a surface sample. Here we go, that should be enough. There we go. We have exactly enough, actually. I don't have to do that at the runway as well. Advanced space exploration. And scanning tech will also have a good, lot of good stuff. So there's something about, like, a cyclotron that one of the experiments needed, which is in here, high power electrics. Yep, that's what it's needed. Which is not feasible at the current moment. I might make a rover to drive around on Minmus. I would need wheels for that, though. Would that be under heavy landing? No, where do you get the wheels from? Down here? Here? There's a truck, but that's not quite what we need. Oh, there. Field science, 300. We have the pack rat. We don't need these wheels. We have the pack rat wheels. Used to make a nice rover. All right. Next up, space station. First up, I'm going to go to the bathroom again. I've been drinking a lot of water. I'll be back. I'm back. Quick trip to the bathroom. Alright, so what do we have for wheels? Oh, we also have those wheels. Those are... Yeah, we have like the fucking buffalo wheels. Those are pretty good. We also have those ones as well. Yeah, we have plenty of different wheels to make cool rovers. Oh, yeah, because like we have the buffalo MESV. Is there any, like, science lab for that? I'm getting distracted. So, I'm gonna have a, I'm gonna use that one. So, we need escape pods to get back, I think, to get the, crew back. So, I believe I have a mod that makes science labs hold 6 Kerbals. So yeah, we're gonna do that. We're gonna need plenty of snacks. How many? Yeah. Snacks. Fucking wrong button. I need to get rid of that mod or fix it. Because it just completely destroys your menu, and you have to leave and re-enter the vehicle assembly building to fix it. Do we have docking ports? Because that would be handy for transferring snacks. Then I could just send up missions to resupply snacks on board the space station, because that will not last. The snacks, like the research lab, cannot recycle the food forever. They're gonna eat shit for a while, is what I'm saying. Alright. Oh, luckily that's saved. Here, how many crew do we have? Yeah, we have 6. So we're gonna go to the astronaut complex and hire like 6 very courageous but also very stupid scientists. I don't even know what those 2 sats do, but they probably do something. All right. Let's still play the music for the that area. Zoology Bay. I need one of these. There's probably a few more scientists, actually, if I'm guessing right. Yep, that's going to be 2 more scientists. We're going to wait to hire a scientist until we're done with this. Oh, we also have the space telescope. Let's do that first, actually, because that'll be easier. And the space telescope is so cool. It's one of my favorite mods that I'm glad got updated. Wait, do we have it? We have the modules. Proceeds to Kerbal Janitor. Hide all except for cacti. Nope, we do not have it. We just have the modules. How do I get the telescope? Might do a very quick mission to do that. Because I really do love the telescope. I mean, the science lab will be fine, though, for now. We'll do that. Telescope can be next time. Telescope. Nope. It's telescoping ladder. Scanning tech? Yeah, it's scanning tech, I think. No, it might not be. Electronics? That's level 2. High power electrics. Oh yeah, there it is. Well, there's some stuff for the telescope and high power electrics. Yeah, this is just like docking bays and shit. The advanced construction has docking ports. I mean, we have Kerbal Inventory System. We can unlock this and then send up an engineer to attach a docking port if we don't have one already. I don't think we have one already, actually. Yeah. If there's one general construction, we have it, but if not, then we don't have a docking port. Where you get to tier 3. Okay. You know, it has to be in this one. Where is the telescope at, though? Oh, fungi telescope optic. What? I should have it. Well, I know what it's called now, so I can search for it. Yeah, what? But I have it, though. I have it, but it is not showing up. That is an issue. Because if I don't have it now, I'm never going to get it. This is zoology, man. How do I get that? Yeah, it's looking like it's going to be in Scanning Tech. Yep. Alright. Launch the space station. Well, let's build the space station, then launch the space station. Anyway, so gonna do opties. Regular science lab. And what's it? Not that one. I think actually this is the only one we can. A fuel. The experiment at least. The experiment module, like right here. How much does it mean? 27.33. All right. Do you want? I think I actually will recover the entire thing. So the way I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna put some winglets on. Just to keep it pointing the correct direction. That. And then, not payload. Heat shield. Right there. Do I have any radial ones? I do not. We're gonna use the ant. Where's the ant? Ant at. Oh, Spark can be used as a radio engine. That should be enough to deorbit. Then we're gonna need a shit ton of parachutes. Oh, we get a little habitation module. That's nice. There they are. We're gonna need some drogue shoes, definitely. Let's do like 8 of them. And regular parachutes, we're gonna need 16. Also, let's put them here so they're shielded from entry. Drogue chutes pull before regular parachutes because they make it safe for the parachutes to be pulled. E-shield, we got that. We got the deorbiting thruster. And yeah, that's fuel tank for science as well as deorbiting. Then we need a decoupler. And I don't think we actually have any 2.5 meter engines yet. Or even anything that can, yeah, we don't. So, let's see if, can this even get wide enough? Yeah, I can. I'm just gonna need to space it out a bit. Do we have anything structural that we can use? This one? Yeah. Space it out a little bit. Scuffed space program. Oh, it doesn't quite make it all the way up to the pod. So we're just gonna do that. That should be enough. So let's make the ejection force fucking crazy. That's fun. And 6 sides. Alright. How do we do this? This is gonna be the orbital insertion tank. Actually, let's just use these ones. That's respectable, actually. Okay, that's a bit too much. We don't need that much fuel at this stage. Yeah, that should be good. God, this rocket is so goddamn scuffed. It's bad. But, you know, that's early science mode, you know? Early science mode is really ridiculous looking. Okay. Something that can lift all this. This one? We're gonna need more of those if I use that one. Also, that doesn't give us enough fuel anyway. Let's try one. Yeah, we're gonna need a lot of these. That should be enough. Except for the fact that the thrust rate ratio isn't good enough. What we're gonna do is this, just to give us a few more engines. We need a few more of these. God, this rocket looks so bad. It's hopefully gonna work though. Oh God. Oh, that's too big. We're not gonna make it look that cursed. That's a bit too cursed. There we go. Got the rocket. No, we don't want to name this untitled spacecraft. The most cursed space station. Oh God. Oh yeah, I just realized there are fins on top, so this thing is gonna really want to flip. I should probably add more fins to the bottom so it doesn't want to flip as hard. But we're gonna try it without doing that first, just to see what happens. I can always revert. All right. Oh, we don't have any scientists. We need scientists for this rocket. Well, I'm gonna add the fins now anyway. So fins first. Oh, actually that's quite a bit of thrust to weight ratio. We don't need quite that many. Yeah, that should be good. We are gonna need more fins though. Take a look at our inner mass versus center lift. Ooh. We need more fins. Just cover this thing in fins. All right, that's good. Making the most cursed space station even more cursed. We need a couple more scientists. All right. Oh, never mind, we had enough. We need snacks. That's something we definitely need to go back for, because I don't think they do science if they are hungry. Big dog. Hi, big dog. Big dog. Big dog probably wants to go outside. And so is the little dog, and I have to watch them. Alright, I'll have to be back. Yeah. I'm gonna make a new alert. Text. Dogs out. Dogs out. Okay. There we go. A little bit smaller. There we go. We'll launch when I get back. I'm back! Get this rocket into space. Cursed ass rocket. It's rising. Somehow. Oh. I gotta turn off the letting dogs out. There we go. Excuse me. Alright. Get them in the void. There's absolutely nothing. That is what they're going to be seeing for the next few years. Also, don't have any snacks. I'm back to vehicle assembly and did not pack any snacks. do that. Is it a utility? I know for a fact that the snacks are a utility, but it doesn't. Would they be under a payload? Oh, they're under payload. All right. Snacks. Let's go for over, just over a year. I don't know why it doesn't let me place items when I have the snacks window open. That's lame. That's chill. I don't want that. Alright. 194 days. No, we need eight more. Oh, wow, that's heavy. These things are heavy. It's still enough to deorbit, so we're good there. Wait, these things only weigh like 0.015 tons each. Well, I suppose I did put down a shit ton of them. Yeah. Also, when filled, they're 150 kilograms. So yeah, that's like a few tons of snacks. That. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna launch with that. We're gonna need more fuel tanks though for that many snacks. Not that many, though. Maybe, like, 4. That'd be 16. No. That's 8. That's 8. Yeah, that should be good enough. Alright. Hey, Gunner, you were just out. All right. Come on now, load my cursed ass rocket. I know I just added like another like 16 parts. All right, there we go. I don't know how long they're gonna be in space for, but yeah. Oh! We don't have enough thrust now. Oh, what's the thrust to weight ratio? Yeah, no. We need more rocket engines. Wow, look at that. Control Z. It's here, just let me know how many, if they didn't quite copy correctly. in the rocket. Yeah, whatever, that's fine. And I think three more should do it. Yeah, there we go. Come on, load. There we go. Now everything should be in order. Yeah. I wait till the thrust rate ratio to go higher before I pitch over to 80. Damn, we're wasting a lot of fuel fighting gravity, but yeah, it should be fine. If not, this will give a good test of the re-entry of this. And let me know if I need to do more to help it land. God, this rocket is so cursed. I didn't put any aerodynamics on that part, but it doesn't matter. Oh, I thought those were cities. No, that's the sky. Because it is nighttime, you know? It is kind of dark, though. Like, the stars, I mean. I mean, obviously, it's dark. It's nighttime. But the stars are pretty dark. Alright. Oh, it's probably not mid. Let's go for 60. Drop down a bit just so we're not fighting the atmosphere as hard. Let's start pitching over and we'll go throttle up. Well, we haven't reached 10 kilometers, but it doesn't matter that much. All's down there. So is Jewel and Val. Because, you know, it's a Jewel system. What is Jewel doing in the ocean, though? Pretty light show. Yep, we are launching a rocket to space. Go more over. And even more. Even more over. Is that G-force? Yeah. Next. It's still like basically burning orbital pearl grade now, so I'm gonna just don't do that. And that stage is out of fuel. On this stage, and you need to go up. Luckily, the atmosphere isn't thick enough to cause this entire thing to just fucking flip. That would be bad. Oop, here's some. And it's up there. Close. Probably like some really far out ones that are hard to see. The naked eye. Ooh. Yeah, there's Sarnus. Hi, Sarnus. I don't know where the other ones are, though. They get any of the moons of Sarnus? Nope. Also, we're high enough that I can just push that. There it goes, real fast. How are you doing in there? Yeah, I guess the mod that makes it so you can put 6 Kerbals in the science lab also doesn't make it so that, that there's an interior. Oh, wait, no, never mind. Yeah, there's an interior. It's just, I guess it's just the nature lab and, the nature lab and the command module do not have the, yeah, just do not have an interior. Yeah, look at that! It's the void! There's an interior there. Yeah. Also, once we get the science lab in orbit, I'm calling stream there. I've been streaming for like 7 hours. Actually, I might see how the science works, but I'm not going to recover at this stream. I'm going to do that next stream. Which will be on Tuesday. So, you know, tune in Tuesday at 3. That's when next stream is, and you can see me probably burn up in the atmosphere. Because the station is cursed and should never have been launched. Does that have reaction wheels? I don't think this thing has reaction wheels. So we won't be able to pick where we go down too easily. Because I'm just going to have to go wherever, whenever it points retrograde to deorbit. Yeah, we're basically almost at orbital speed. I suppose before I decide to let's turn on the lights. Pretty. I suppose before I decide to like deorbit, like wherever I want to do it, I can just boot up the engines just a little bit to point retrograde, and then go full throttle. That'd probably work. There we go. Right. And this should not take that much fuel. Yep. Only 100 meters a second of delta V. Now, does this have reaction wheels? It does not appear to. I am holding down the buttons. Yeah, I'm not going back again to get reaction wheels. So we're just gonna have to deal. And I know how to deal. Additional fat. Yo. Oh boy. Okay. Well. Nope. I mean, it's a cursed station. It can be in a cursed orbit, really. I could have launched this thing into a polar orbit. That would have been funny. Yeah, that's circular enough. Yeah, there we go. So now we can do some science. Third experiment. What are Eurekas? Does this generate Eurekas? Start research. Start lab time. Okay, and snack processor. There we go. Oh, I accidentally clicked snack time. That wasted like probably a day's worth of food. Oh well. And how does this one work? Start research. Okay. It is researching. Transmit science. Oh, okay. Oh. Needs power, huh? All right, ending stream there. I forgot to put any kind of power generation on this. So, next stream, we're gonna launch the research station again. But this time... Or, next stream, we're gonna rock it again, but that time, we're gonna actually put power on it. In fact, last thing we do this stream, we're gonna put power on the research station. So it can do research. Because you kinda need electricity to do research. It might as well put some gyros on it as well. Alright. Some batteries. Actually, let's just use the extra, these batteries. A solid ring down there. Control Z until we get the back. I don't know where it went. Okay. Need two more to get those back, and then we can fairing back, so I don't have to build it again. There we go, we got the fairing back. Alright, we have enough building, so yeah. Hope that, yeah, just copy the fairing. Give it a second. No! He just copied the fucking fairing again. Stop doing that! Fine, I won't copy the battery. I'll just take it from there. There we go. Alright. Got that. What was that? Oh yeah, we need power generation. Which so far, all I have are these. So we're just gonna need a fairing. Bane of my existence. Alright. Solar. More solar. Because these panels are kind of shit, and those need a lot of, these probably need a lot of power. Power. That needs 5 a second. Alright. See, we're gonna need a lot of solar panels. And this one needs, I don't know what it needs. Alright. I copied the shell again, the airstream shell. Again. God. Okay. Got that. And do one more layer. There we go. That should be plenty of solar panels for next time. Save it there. And yeah, that's the stream. Hope you had fun. And I'll find someone to raid. I'm just gonna raid whoever is elite, or if not one I know is streaming, I'm just gonna raid whoever is the least things on here. Alright. Is someone I know streaming? Nope. So I'm just gonna raid whoever has least, followers on, or least watchers on Kerbal Space Program. Man Under a Rock is who we will be raiding. There we go. Start raid. And goodbye.